missed you. I missed you. Did I hit record?
It's Pillow Talk, Pillow Talk, Pillow Talk, hey. Pillows and playing video games.
I don't think I synced my audio last time. Oh, shit. Oh, that's gonna. I'm gonna hate myself. I'm going to absolutely hate myself. Oh no. Oh no. I am. Oh no. That's not good. Sorry. Woo. All right. All right. All right. Okay. It was only on one episode. Oh man. I'm freaking out about that. All right. So this is going to be an interesting fight of sorts. I don't know how this is going to go. So let's do it. There weren't any secrets on here. No, I don't think so. Ah, should we check? Yeah, I guess. This walling reminds me of, a church in Jackson, Michigan. Okay, so a little quick recap on the lore. So, all the blood that the people of Yharnam receive that, you know, is like the penicillin equivalent to our world. They got their blood from a fallen old one, and we are about to fight the fallen old one. So all that blood that the church collected and harvested, they took from this old one right over there. And That's the source of all the blood. So that's what's caused like the men to turn into beasts. Well, the men of Yharnam, men and women, the people of Yharnam to turn into beasts. Strange things, creatures happening, things like this stuff, all this horror and that, all stems from this, Ebrietus, daughter of the cosmos. Look at, watch this character walk. The head bobs, so it's like I'm listening to music and bobbing my head. Like, I have some sick jams on right now. I'm listening to Soul Sister by Train. Oh, jeez. Okay. So, this is going to be really interesting. Oh, God, you are ugly. Joshua didn't know the front of this creature was its head when he first fought it. It was pretty funny. The key is just to get right up in here, in the middle. Because she kind of like twists you around with her, so you don't have to keep rolling and doing this shit like I am. But you don't want to get far away from her because she does laser beams and stuff. Not fun. God, you are. You are. Quick. Oh, damn it. Has anyone ever called you Shamu? I have barely done any damage to her. This is going to be a pain in the butt. Ooh, 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 ooh. Ooh, damn. Damn, son. Oh, she killed me. Why'd I try to use magic there? I tried to get fancy and tried to use the magic and it didn't work out. So I'm gonna drink my LaCroix. This episode is sponsored by LaCroix. No. Oh, fuck. It's go time. I've been training my life for this. This very moment. I didn't send the elevator back up. Damn it! Come at me, beast! I am going to try using this gun, though, and I'm going to regret it. This gun. Sword. Wow. Idiot. Ooh. 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 Hey, what's up, Jelly Belly? Cue that music. You just like, she totally just gave me a bitch slap. God, you are ugly. Is it because I called you ugly? Okay, I guess so. Oh, damn. Ooh, I dodged the shit out of that. Oh, Oh, damn. Okay. All right. You really showed me, big tough girl. It's go time. You know what? I am not looking towards some boss fights at the end. I am not. Oh, shit. Does she do a thing? Is she doing a thing? Oh, shit. She did a thing. Woo! Oh, woo! Woo! Oh, I forgot about that. Oh, damn. Whoo, baby. Oh, God. I thought I had it, too. Oh, this might be a problem. I don't know how else I can prepare for this. I really don't. Just stick with these guys? Yeah, I think I'm just going to have to stick with my Blades of Mercy, the good old try and true, you know? I got beast pellets I should probably be using. I'm not going to be using the Tonitrus, so we're going to just deselect that for right now. No, we gotta mean business. We can't try stuff right now. Not when we're fighting an old one. Even a fallen one at that, but, you know. Mumbo number 5. Let's do this. Oh, Amygdala, that was the other one. I couldn't be. I hope this doesn't turn into an Amygdala. I really don't. Start that music. See, I had to mean business. Couldn't mess around, like, God forbid. So, this next part I'm very excited for. So, if you don't remember, a couple episodes ago, I'm very excited, I've never done this before. If you remember a couple episodes ago, we followed and finished Alfred's quest line, and it ended with him killing the Vilebloods, who we were a part of. Well, we just used it for the store. So, he ends up not killing her, but smashing her to a bloody pulp so she can't, you know, be, you know, do anything anymore, and then Alfred, you know, dies. But this is an altar to the old ones, and we can offer that bloody bit of flesh that we found on her throne. Time flows in reverse for this scrap of flesh. And then if we travel back to Kanehurst Castle, our queen will be there. Very excited. This is going to be so cool. Huh? And look at that. Our queen is here. Ah! What's up? Arrant fool. Vile blood or no, forget not bend. Oh, yeah. So, isn't that pretty neat? So you can complete Alfred's quest line and still end up doing the vile blood stuff. So cool. So cool. And that's just like a little touch that can just be thrown in the game, you know? A little bit of code. Like, this activates this. Like, it's not that hard. Like, damn. That's so cool. Okay, that was good. Oh, yeah. Do I have any better gems for my Blades of Mercy? It's okay. I refuse to do the Chalice Dungeons. Yes, I have beaten the Chalice Dungeons. I got the trophy for that for my Platinum. Never touching them again. Never. Never, ever, ever, never. Never. Oh, I wonder how much of this we can get done in this session. We have 3 more episodes left. This is exciting. Ah, damn. think this is like the strongest one of these dudes. I want chunks, man. Give me them chunks, dude. Open sesame. Treasure chest. Hello. Blood chunk. Okay, really? Madman's knowledge right there? Really? That's the item you put at the end of the rainbow? That's what leprechaun gold really is? Really? Really? Oh, jeez. How many of there are you? Okay, gotta go there. But we gotta finish exploring this. The nameless moon presence, hint, hint. The three chords, hint, hint. That's for the secret ending, which I've decided we are doing, because then you'll be able to have seen all the bosses in Bloodborne on this run-through. Well, excluding Chalice Dungeons, but they don't count because, again, stupid. Anything down here? Any door? Nope. Dead end? Just make-out corner for the students. Ring, ring. It's time for my bling, bling. Hunt the great ones. Hunt the great ones. So now we're hinting at what was being taught at you know, Bergenworth, which were was the old ones. To see, you need the eyes. Remember the eyes. That's what Willem said. Another note. You just learn all these tidbits of knowledge right here. Master Willem was right. Evolution without courage would be ruin of our race. See, that it's so cool. Like, he's kind of like brainwashed and like fucked up these students. I mean, look at these guys. But I was going to say something else and I totally forgot what it was. It was something about Willem. I don't remember. Because he was all about evolving the human race and he thought that was done through the great ones. Oh, it's awesome. I'm happy. Very happy. Oh my gosh, this Scoopy. Spooky. I don't remember having to come out that hole. And oh, am I not near the lamp? I thought I was closer to the lamp. Yeah, that tunnel was creepy is what I was trying to get at. The Argan woman rings a sinister bell. Oh no. Ooh, it's something else. Oh. Oh, yeah. These things. They're worms. Yes. I guess we can mess with the sword now. That's exciting. I get to mess with the sword. Oh, he just was taking me away. Three blood chunk. Holy. I'm close. So this is a really cool bit about environmental storytelling in this game. A really fine example. So, you're running past this statue, you know. You see this guy with the item. You go over, you grab the item. Okay? Then you notice all these spears in that inside him. And you're like, what? What is, you know, what is causing, what killed this man, you know? You don't even pay attention. You just see, oh, you got speared or whatever. But you come up here over the hill, you see that, you're like, what's going on with that? And you're immediately stabbed with spears. Just like that guy. Environmental storytelling. It was preparing you for what was going to happen. And if you would have picked up on it, you would know that it would have been frenzy because it was from the eyeball creatures from earlier that we saw. How crazy is that? Design. Good game design. That's a fine example right there. Anyway, thank you all for watching. This episode is way too long. Have a wonderful